Welcome to final BSc statistics students. Today we discuss lesson 6 of unit 3 of paper 6, in which we discuss two more definitions, producer's risk and consumer's risk. In the last lesson, previous lesson, we have discussed the three definitions. AOQ, average outgoing quality. AQL, acceptance quality level. LTPD, lot tolerance percent defective. Now today we discuss producer's risk and consumer's risk. So which are two usual definitions we have already learnt in the second year. What is meant by producer's risk? Rejecting the good lot. The producer face in some situations, a lot is going to be rejected by the consumer. A good lot is going to be rejected by the consumer. That is, even though good qualitative items are produced by the manufacturer or producer, the company, but lot is going to be rejected. Rejecting the good lot. That is the definition of producer's risk. That is the risk of producer. That is a risk of producer. In which what I define one particular terminology of incoming lot quality again. It is also incoming lot quality. The small p we have considered in AOQ is incoming lot quality or fraction defective. And in AQL, we have considered it as average number of defectives, proportionate number of defectives. In LTPD, we have considered it as PT, maximum proportionate number of defective items which can be tolerated by the consumer. Like that, it was changed from one definition to another definition. A small change, but it is the same definition. Same particular P notation is changed into separate kinds of definitions. The meaning, only slight difference in the meaning. Meaning differs. So therefore here we consider P bar, the process average percent defective. Process average percent defectives. Process average percent defective means it is observed in some number of lots by considering, by testing some number of lots. It is being observed. That is why it was terminated. It is denoted as, abbreviated as, specified as P bar. P bar average. That is, for example, in the first lot we observed, we inspected the lot, which means based on the sample we inspected the lot. Lot was inspected, that is sample inspected and lot information given to lot, like the same procedure. And we got some particular P1. In the second lot we got another P2, and so on. For 100 lots, previous 100 lots information we are gathering. We are considering the previous 100 lots. That is inspection of 100 lots in the previous time period. We have considered that P1, P2 and so on, P100, etc. For which we are calculating average, that is P bar. P bar is an average for those P's, for all P's which are identified in the previous inspection of the lots. That is what it is known as P bar. Though it is P bar is going to be calculated in the example is P1 plus P2 and so on plus P100 divided by 100. It is nothing but P bar. Like that, P bar was observed, is going to be calculated. The process average percent defective, for which we consider 100 into P bar. Actually, for both we are writing process average percent defectives. We write as defectives. In the both the terminology we write the same, but if you consider this is p bar, for example p bar is 2%, then 100 into p bar gives process average percent defective items, process average percent of defective items, the average number of defective items in the process. It specifies in a particular process what are the average percentage of defective items. It gives 100 into p bar. If p bar is 2%, 100 into p bar is 2. Therefore, it gives process average percent defective items. Average percent of defective items, simply to specify. With this particular 100 p bar, we have to calculate a probability, that is probability of rejecting the lot. Probability of rejecting the lot, which is considered as 100 into p bar, process average percent defectives. That is a good lot, because it is observed in many number of lots. So that it was specified as 100 p bar is process average percent defectives, which was observed a good lot. So now producer's risk is going to be calculated by the formula, that is producer's risk is going to be calculated with this particular formula. It is denoted by PP and is also can be denoted by alpha, and is probability of rejecting the lot with 100 p bar process average percent defectives. I write defectives with the lot quality. Probability of rejecting the lot with the quality 100 into p bar process average percent defectives. We are rejecting this, but it is good, but we are rejecting it. That is the risk of producer. The lot quality is good because we are taken from many number of lots. We are observed from many number of lots. By inspecting the many number of lots, by observing this kind of thing which was taken place, this is the proportionate number of defective items, average number of defective items which are observed in the many number of lots. Therefore, it is treated as a good lot, which means number of defective items are less, minimum, as minimum as possible, then in such a case, that is the case we are considering. If it is less, then my argument is good. My argument is it is a good lot. Then my argument is a good lot because it is taken from a repetitive process and from the previous time periods. I have considered many number of lots and I did this particular procedure, and so that I came to a conclusion that 100 people are process average percent defectives, which leads to a good lot. If it is a good lot and we are rejecting it, then that is nothing but producer's risk. So therefore, producer's risk is going to be calculated by PP is equal to, it is alpha, it is also denoted as alpha, probability of rejecting the lot with the quality with 100%, 100 into p bar defective items, 100 into p bar process average percent defectives. This is producer's risk. Now come to the consumer's risk. The risk of the consumer, when it took place, if you are accepting the bad lots in any particular process, for example, if the bad quality lot is not good, there is bad lot, it consists of more number of defective items than specified items, then if we are accepting that particular lot, then that is a risk of the consumer, and that is a risk of the consumer. Usually, that is some particular lot consists of undesirable proportionate number of defective items, that is the terminology is going to be used. If a lot consists of undesirable proportionate number of defective items, then then the consumer is going to be accepting the bad lot. At that particular proportionate level, proportionate defective items, if you are accepted, consumer is going to be accepted the lot, then that is nothing but risk of the consumer. So for which you recollect the definition LTPD, lot tolerance percent defective. There you observe the word tolerance. It is the maximum level of tolerance. It is the maximum probability, the maximum number of defective items which can be tolerated by the consumer. There we have specified as PT. The same PT I am considering here. We consider here in the definition of consumer's risk as well, because this is the maximum tolerance limit. Maximum tolerated probability, proportionate number of defective items. Maximum tolerate proportionate defective items. It can be tolerated. The PT or more. We have specified very clearly in LTPD. Recall the definition. PT or more proportionate defective items. If a lot consists of PT or more proportionate defective items, then it is said to be. Then it is said to be. Lot tolerance percent defective with 100 into PT is known as LTPD. That is rejecting quality level. You recollect the definition also we have specified there. Rejecting quality level is nothing but PT, directly PT. That is at which particular proportionate defective items the probability we reject a lot. It is not acceptable by the consumer. That is nothing but rejecting quality level. But whereas if it is accepted, it is a risk of consumer. That quality level is accepted by the consumer, it is a risk of consumer. So therefore, what I am specifying? I am specifying here with the formula. That is the formula of the consumer's risk. It is going to be calculated with PC. PC is the notation of the consumer's risk with the in terms of probability. Probability of accepting the lot with lot quality with PT proportionate defective items, PT defectives. With PT proportionate defective items. So PC is nothing but probability of accepting the lot with PT proportionate defective items, which means whatever the tolerated probability, the tolerated limit of number of defective items which are going to be accepted, actually it is going to be rejected, but it is accepted, that is going to be calculated by PC. The another notation, it is beta, it is also denoted by beta. PC is beta, which is nothing but probability of accepting the lot with PT number of defective items, PT defective items, PT defectives. So PT is a probability, remember, actually it is a probability. PT is a probability, proportionate number of defective items, PT or more defectives, proportionate number of defective items, that is only you consider in such a fashion only. PC is probability of accepting the lot with PT proportionate number of defective items, PT proportion of defective items, right? This is denoted by beta, and the producer's risk is PP, consumer's risk is PC. Okay, hope you are recollect again the formula. Producer's risk PP is calculated by probability of rejecting the lot with 100 P bar process average percent defectives. That is also denoted by alpha. Consumer's risk, it is calculated by PC, risk of the consumer. Probability of accepting the lot with PT proportionate defective items, defectives, it is denoted by beta. Hope you understand. Thank you.